Welcome to our first virtual award ceremony, Leaders by Head and Heart, organized by the ASEAN Network. Thanks to all participants who join us and to all our awardees tonight. The ASEAN Network is a digital community of 400 business and young leaders promoting the role of technology to improve social, environmental, and economic outcomes, but also sustainable development goals from the United Nations. The ASEAN Network is also committed to support gender equality and youth empowerment. I do believe personally that all together, collectively, we can support each other and achieve more for a better future. Tonight is a celebration of 10 fantastic and inspiring leaders from India, Nepal, Bangladesh, Hong Kong, Philippines, and Cambodia in their respective fields from health, social impact, education to leadership, peace, agriculture, and environment. Tonight is also a reminder that we are all facing global challenges, and one way to tackle this challenge is with empathy and compassion to support those who need it most. For this reason, we are supporting Oxygen for India, a non-profit led by Mr. Ramanan Lakshminarayan, former advisor of Obama Council on Science and Technology, a volunteer-run campaign to deliver life-saving medical oxygen as quickly as possible. So the ASEAN Network and myself would like to thank our main sponsor, ERIA, the Economic Research Institute for ASEAN and East-Asia, is Julia Ashmone-Marsan, who believed from the beginning to the mission and vision of the ASEAN Network. To all the awardees, again, congratulations for your dedication and passion and for your valuable work for your community, society, and country. I would like to end with this quote of Martin Luther King: a good head and a good heart are always a formidable combination. If your head tells you one thing and your heart tells you another, before you do anything, you should first decide whether you have a better head or a better heart. Now, I would like to give you the floor to His Excellency Franz Jensen, former EU ambassador to the Philippines, for the opening remarks.
Thank you very much, Rabindra. The ASEAN Network is built on two great interrelated strengths. It is geographically placed in the growth center of the world, And its second strength is demographic. It is at the center of a young and dynamic population. The ASEAN network brings together over 400 young leaders, demonstrating that progress and ideas transcend borders. Young people in Asia share many of the same aspirations. They share the same hopes, the same concerns, and many of the same challenges. In order to make progress, we need not only cold and objective analysis to find the best solutions, we also need our heart to tell us what are the right things to do. Ravinder New has done a tremendous job in bringing young thought leaders together and to share their ideas within the ASEAN network. Issues such as health tech, smart cities, robotics, and AI, just to name a few, are issues that go beyond national borders, issues that require both head and heart in order to shape the best possible future for us all. The past year has shown us how much interdependent the world has become. Health challenges such as COVID-19 spread quickly across the world once they appear. Today, global challenges are very real and they have multiplied. This also means that any solution has to be shared in order to be effective. Global challenges such as viruses, even poverty, do not care about national boundaries, and no one country can isolate itself from the impact. The past year has for many been a sad year. Many have lost loved ones, many have been afraid, many are worried about the future, and we have seen how many also have tried to seek safety within their own national groups. But we have also seen that no one country has managed to successfully isolate itself from the challenges in a sustainable manner. We have to work together. Looking ahead, we do unfortunately face a challenge that is much larger than COVID-19. I am, of course, referring to climate change. This summer, we have read many stories about record-breaking temperatures, climatic challenges, rising water levels, all consequences of climate change. If we are to solve the climate change challenge, it will require an unprecedented international cooperation, a cooperation at a level that we have so far never seen. If we continue to focus on our national differences, then I have little hope that we will be able to overcome the climate change challenge. Here, truly, head and heart are both needed to find a solution. The leaders by head and heart have shown ways to make progress in different areas, in tech, used in health, AI, robotics, in peace, in leadership, in fighting poverty, in overcoming disabilities, in environment, and in education. Let us all be inspired by the stories that leaders by head and heart have shared with us. Their stories all show that head and heart are both needed, and so is working together across national boundaries, across national borders, if we are to overcome the challenges we are facing. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Excellency Franz Jensen, for your opening remarks and your support for this event, but also for the ASEAN network since its inception. We will now start with our first batch of awardees. Each will have around 3 minutes to share a message from their leadership and experience. We are happy to welcome Mr. Ryan Hasava, our first awardee leader by Head and Heart from the Philippines, for his social impact work with Virtual Lahan. Ryan is a multi-awarded social entrepreneur, educator, and disability champion. He is also an Ashoka Fellow and honorary for Forbes 30 Under 30 Asia for social impact. Welcome, Ryan, and congratulations again.
Yes, I was talking about the most important lesson I learned in doing social impact for over half a decade, and that is intentional leadership. The conscious effort of driving an organization to the point where it no longer needs you as the primary decision maker, and that requires head and heart. At Virtual Lahan, our leadership team is composed of graduates of our program. We entrust the key decisions to people who experienced our impact formula, and in the process, allowing the organization to be truly community-driven. At Virtual Lahan, we are breaking down employment barriers for people with disabilities, out-of-school youth, solo parents, prisons inside the jail, indigenous people, and other excluded communities using the equalizing power of technology. We are using an impact formula that combines digital skills training, employment and entrepreneurship support, life coaching, and community building delivered through an inclusive, cost-effective, and transferable virtual platform. And as a result, persons with disabilities and other excluded communities are provided with skills, mindset, and economic opportunities to become productive while helping businesses and organizations in building a diverse and inclusive future. Doing social impact work is extremely challenging and exhausting. And the only way for organizations like us to thrive is to build more leaders inside to share the pain and the joy. That way, the organization is more protected, resilient, and deliver bigger impact. Tonight, I would like to express my gratitude and congratulations to all leaders who are working hard to make our world less problematic. To the ASEAN Network and Ravindra for creating this platform, maraming salamat and mabuhay.
Thanks, Ryan. Our next awardee is Dr. Radhika Batra from India, and we congratulate her with Every Infant Matters, a nonprofit organization dedicated to the improvement of disadvantaged children worldwide. Radhika believes in inclusion and health equality and wants to ensure access to healthcare for all. She's a Forbes Asia 30 Under 30 honoree. Dr. Radhika, the floor is yours.
Hi, thank you so much for this incredible honor, Ravinder. Am I audible?
Very good.
I am audible, all right. So I'm Dr. Radhika Batra. I am the founder and president of Every Infant Matters, a nonprofit organization which focuses on ubiquitous access to healthcare worldwide. In the last 1 year, we have been largely focusing our energies on COVID relief, be it running a 24/7 COVID helpline, a COVID task force for the people of India, be it setting up centers in Manipur and the Northeast where there are no health services, be it sending concentrators to, you know, all over the country where we thought that access to oxygen is very much needed. And the only thing I realized in this pandemic was that, you know, as is the theme of this event, you have to lead with your head and, you know, you really have to think from your heart. Because when you think from your heart, you come and you lead from a position of love. You think about people, you think about humanity, you factor in humanity in all of your acts. You are driven to be more compassionate, more kind, more empathetic to the suffering of everybody around. And that's what ultimately makes you a social entrepreneur and it makes you a good leader. So thank you so much for this, this incredible honor. The ASEAN Network, and I really look forward to listening to the other awardees, to hearing what they have to say. And we've already seen what Oxygen for India has done, and that's absolutely mind-blowing. I mean, hats off to you guys, and hats off to all the winners. Heartiest congratulations, and thank you so much once again.
Thanks, Radhika. Our third awardee is from Cambodia. Mr. Richard Yim is the president of D-Mine Robotics, a company that is building technology to clear explosives such as landmine and improvised explosive devices. In 2018, he was named to Forbes Asia 30 Under 30. He thanks Richard for his commitment to Cambodia and D-Mine Robotics. The floor is yours, Richard.
Thank you so much. So today I want to talk about leadership. I think Ravindra asked, like, you know, what is leadership? And you know, I actually have quite a lot of trouble finding how to describe leadership. Because for me, when I look at other leaders, like all the other speakers in this group, I can say, you know, they are leaders. But to identify myself as leader, that's always been a problem for me. And time and times again, people would ask me, what is leadership? How you would identify those that are leadership? And that has been a big challenge for me. So the short answer is, I don't know. But within the next 3 minutes, I will give you a 3-minute answer of what is leaders. And for me, I like to pinpoint, you know, as an engineer, I like to always have a definite definition or requirement of what would consider as leaders. So if leaders have A, B, and C, then they would be leaders. And I've tried to come up with that list. And to tell you the truth, I can't. And the reason why I can't is I feel like every leaders have different quality and different characteristics and different traits that make them leaders. So, you know, if the leader help their coworker or help their workers with financial help, would that consider a leader? So people have money, would that consider them a leader? I don't think so. What if people have a lot of people that work for them? Would that make them automatically a leader? And, you know, that may be one of the quality. So it's very hard to pinpoint what's leadership. But my answer to describe leadership gonna involve a pyramid scheme concept, which probably raised a lot of red flag to those that listen right now. But hold on a second. Hold on to the pyramid scheme idea 1 second. I'm going to get back to that. So I think everyone can agree that we need more leaders because leaders have a really positive trait. Even though we cannot list them all, you know, leader probably would be responsible, reliable, a problem solving, is a pillar within an organization, creativity, inspiring. I would say all those qualities can make up a leader, but not mutually exclusive, or not only those that have those quality would consider as a leaders. But we can say that leaders have positive quality. So I think it's fair to say that if we have more leaders in the world can be a better place. And using my own experience, I have a hard time identifying myself as a leader. So it's hard for me, in my opinion, to become a leader. But it's easy for me to identify those that are leaders. So in a way, I can help other people to become leaders, because when they become a leader, I can see and I can tell that they are leaders. So this is my answer. My answer, what if we, everyone, help those around us to become leaders, to become the next generation of leadership? And so even if we cannot become a leader ourselves, if all of us can inspire leaders in the next generation more, and hopefully that message push through across to them, and they will inspire more leaders that they surround themselves with, and more of those building a pyramid scheme of leadership. So let's do that. And that is my thought on leadership. And I'm glad to be a part of these amazing leaders. And hopefully one day I can learn from all of these leaders and help inspire those around me. So thank you very much.
Thanks, Richard, for this inspiring message. Our next awardee is Ms. Von Leong from Singapore. Von is a strategic advisor to companies, startups, and family offices. She's also a co-founder at Purpose Venture Capital, building tech ventures that deliver on the UN Sustainable Development Goals. We congratulate Von for her implications to fight COVID in Singapore with Mask for All Singapore. Congratulations, Von, the floor is yours. You need to unmute yourself, Von.
Thank you, Ravitra. Good evening, everyone. My name is Vaughn. You'll see that my name, Vaughn, has three letters, V-O-N. And they stand for what I believe about leadership. V is volition, the act to make your own decisions. Let's start by first imagining a world where everyone, regardless of their background, race, gender, or age, could fulfill their full potential. Next, let's imagine a world where each country measures well-being instead of just the gross domestic product, GDP. And let's imagine a world that all of us are living well. Well-being is an optimal state that allows people to achieve their potential through both the individual pursuit of wellness, progress, and the support of the communities to which they belong. Sadly, 186 million people have been infected with COVID-19, and 4 million have died. One third of the cases are, in fact, in Asia. We are all still trying to manage the pandemic and be very much alert of the next waves from the highly contagious Delta variant. People are getting fatigued and they are burning out. For example, in my country, Singapore, there has been a spike in domestic violence and a surge in mental health issues across the nation. This is a wake-up call to all of us. We must create a better future in health and well-being. And O stands for ownership. This may be the worst of times, yet it can bring out the best of us. For example, inspired by one group of neighbors that started sewing reusable cloth masks at their homes when our country is in short supply of masks, along with my co-founders, we started the Mask for All SG movement to advocate the culture of mask wearing 1 month before it became mandatory in Singapore. In just 2 weeks of setting up, we received immediate support from 19 partners and 6,500 volunteers to make and distribute more than 500,000 masks to the communities. We are just one of the many that stepped up during the crisis. So owning the will to create a way to move us to a better future is ownership. And N stands for network. It takes a village, a team, collaboration with professionals, investors, entrepreneurs, governments, and businesses to provide resources and build effective solutions. Let us create the infrastructure and the environment to empower people and communities to achieve an improved state of physical and mental well-being. My name is Vaughn. As a co-founder at Purpose Venture Capital, Mask for All SG, and the co-chair for American Chamber of Singapore Small and Medium Enterprises Committee, I focus on working with partners and investors to build sustainable tech companies that will advance a greater future of well-being for our communities. This is why I'm so grateful to be among leaders today, because it gives me hope and confidence that together with volition, ownership, and a network like the Asian Network, we can build a better future for all. Congratulations, everyone, and thank you.
Thank you, Vaughn, for this message to our community and to all participants tonight. Now, our last awardee for her first batch is Mr. Pradeep Pariyar from Nepal. Pradeep was recently appointed by the Government of Nepal Ministry of Youth and Sport as a task force member to review the national youth policy and to build Youth Vision 2025. In March 2020, he was nominated Young Global Leader by the World Economic Forum. Tonight, we congratulate Pradeep for his implication for social justice and peace in Nepal. Thanks, Pradeep. The floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Ravindra. It's a great pleasure to be here. I'd like to begin a special thank you to Ravindra Ji and ASEAN Network for organizing Leaders by Head in Heart Award ceremony. It is an honor to be here. Talking about leadership, for me, a leader is someone who leads by example. A leader is someone who has the courage to be honest, someone who has a critically reflect upon oneself. Leading for me is navigating towards the correct right direction. In truth, leadership is power, and the capacity to make right exercise of that power is true leadership for me. Leadership is also about making sacrifice and knowing when to pass on the torch to others. Most of the time we are holding the power all the time. When we're talking about the leadership, same people all the time in the leadership. That's one of the difficult in Asian society. Leadership is about taking less and giving more. In a nutshell, leadership is not forgetting one's community, citizen, and leading by keeping them at the core. So community is core for me. In my opinion, Leadership requires three important characters. The first one is courage. One must have courage to persistently move ahead even at unprecedented difficult time. For example, we have a COVID-19 right now and it's a difficult time. So leadership need to work hard and smart in this difficult time. The second one is the capacity to take a leap when necessary. That's one of the important things as a leader. Third, the youth characteristically seek change instantly, fast. That's the characteristic of young people. That brings me to my third important trait of a leader, which is passion. We need to learn to have a patience. So that's my third one. Now let me tell you briefly about the community and the cause. I work for most marginalized community, so-called untouchable in South Asia. So imagine not being allowed to fetch or even touch the water from a public water spot in a place you call home. Imagine being a best friend with a schoolmate whose house you can't set foot into. Or being a sculptor who carves statues of God only to be prohibited from entering a temple. That kind of situation we are dealing simply because you were born in the society ideology of lower caste families. That is how the lives has been carved for ages of Dalits in South Asia. We stand at the intersection of socioeconomic and political oppression and are deprived of basic human rights in almost every walk of their lives due to wide-ranging discriminatory practices. Only recently, a young Dalit man from village in western Nepal, along with five others, was brutally murdered by 17 villagers because he dared to marry a girl from a higher caste. So that kind of situation here in Nepal and other South Asian countries. In conclusion, I make an appeal to the young people and others to take a leadership in making a better world, creating a just future. So that's one of the important things we need to do in this difficult time. Thank you very much for listening, and thank you very much for organizing this important event in this crisis time. Thank you, Ravindra, and entire ASEAN Network team. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pradeep, for sharing your vision and of leadership and your commitment and your work in Nepal. Now it's time to have an interlude with a duo of violinists, with Joan Yeo and Josh Kua, before our second batch of awardees. See you after. Thanks, Joanne and Josh, for supporting the award ceremony Leaders by Head and Heart Season 1. We congratulate now our next awardee, Mr. Richard Reki from India, for his award of leadership. Richard is currently a board member of KPMG Dubai, the former chief executive officer of KPMG in India. He has more than 36 years of experience in professional service, and he is admired for his expertise toward corporate governance and enterprise risk management. Thanks, Richard. The floor is yours.
Good evening, everybody, and thank you, Ravindran, for this award. Truly appreciate it, and I would like to congratulate all the other 9 awardees on this platform for the exemplary work that they have done. My life, I just thought I will share a few nuggets of my life, my professional journey with each of you. My entire journey has been in consulting, and I've anchored my life on the 4 P's: people, passion, pride, and purpose. And this has helped me make this journey very meaningful. I truly believe in higher purpose and in the spirit of stewardship. Stewardship means holding something in trust to give it back to the next person or to the next generation better than what you got it. And that is something that I have followed right through my professional life. I've always acted from my heart. The values have been the bedrock of what I've built my life on, and they have helped me take right decisions. My personal higher purpose has been to put the firm before self and work to making it the best place possible. Humility, simplicity, and compassion have been my constant companions. There is no substitute for hard work, perseverance, and being disciplined. In my view, titles are given, but respect is earned. And we all need to work hard to earn that respect. When our titles are taken away, we will realize what we actually meant to the people we worked with. I've always believed in giving back to society to help the less fortunate and bring a difference in their lives. Life is a circle. What goes up ultimately comes down. You treat people well on the way up, that's the exact way you'll be treated on your way down. The one advice I will give everybody is learn to have a mentor very early in your life. I was fortunate to get one, and that truly helped me become what I became. I've always worked to building relationships and not being transactional. It is very important to have a strong network, and it is tested in the times of crisis. I've believed in empowering people and helping them achieve their dreams and aspirations. Always be grateful to all the people who helped you in your journey. Don't forget to thank them. Put in that extra 10% every time you go out to do something, and always remain relevant, because especially in these changing times. My greatest learnings have come from my failures. That's the time I truly tested my reservoir of my skills and talent. And it made me a much stronger and a more determined individual. Always be proud of your scars, because each of them tell a story. I would like to conclude by saying your life has purpose, your story is important, your dreams count, and they become a reality. Your voice matters. You were born to make an impact. Live life in such a way that when tomorrow comes and you're not here, how would you like to be remembered? Thank you.
Thank you, Richard, for sharing your vision of leadership. Our next awardee is from Singapore, and we would like to thank Dr. Drew Seng Tan for his work and passion education. Dr. Tan is a multiple award-winning educator, including the Nanyang Education Award in 2016 and Teaching Excellence Award in 2020. He was also a member of the Singapore Ministry of Education University Autonomy Funding and Governance Working Committee. His most recent white paper, Leadership in the New Normal and the Digital Universe, has been published on Nanyang Business School Knowledge in August 2020. Welcome, Dr. Zhu Seng.
Thank you very much, Ravindra, and to the Asian Network for this distinguished accolade and award. Also like to congratulate all the awardees for tonight's event. It's a great honor to be here and be able to share in this 3 minutes about my thoughts on leadership. I've been working in education, tertiary education, for more than 25 years now in Singapore. And over the last 10 years has been the area of digital leadership. Since the topic tonight is about leading by head and heart, I would like to use this 3H to share my thoughts about digital leadership: head, heart, and hands. This I would consider a more of an integrated, holistic, even a human-centric approach as companies, industries, countries embark on transformation, digital technological transformation. This part here, we're going to talk about three things. The first is about the head. I think leaders will need to envision the future and be guided by a clear North Star. That's the purpose and the direction for the organization or for the country or for the government, for any entity out there. Today, we live in a world of constant change, constant disruption. So it makes it much harder to have a view, a clear view of the future, where we are going, where we are heading. But essentially, this is a leadership challenge and leaders need to rise up to take on this challenge. I call this the head challenge, to envision a clear future. This means that leaders need to draw on their strategic thinking, even more on their imagination, not just their knowledge of what they know, but also their imagination to envision that future for their business, for their company, for their people, for their country. The other part, of course, the head is the wisdom to be able to forge aspirational vision that will motivate and mobilize the people, not just within a company, but also within countries as well. This is to ensure there's alignment and commitment of the leadership team, those in government, to be able to put forth a compelling case for the change or the new direction that's needed. The second point is about the heart. The heart is where leaders need to inspire and empower their people. Transformation sometimes can view as no technology or budgets or resources or some targets or key performance indicators. But transformation is really more than that. People are at the heart of any transformation. So looking at people is really important, especially during these difficult and challenging times in the midst of the pandemic. People are important. People need to know that leaders care for them. So this part here is where people are engaged. So leaders need to spend time, invest time and energy, not just talking about the vision, but also be able to show genuine and real concern for the people going through change. Some are coping better with the changes and some are not. And therefore, it is important for leaders to be able to identify those who are left behind so they can be brought together along the change process. The third aspect is about the last H, the hands. Working with leaders in the digital transformation era, I'm reminded about the importance of agility. So in these uncertain times, so there's a lot of volatility, uncertainty, leaders need to be able to execute, but they also need to be able to drive change and also demonstrate agility in the process. So it's a constant struggle for leaders in terms of trying to drive execution, but also become more resourceful as they cope with constraints, as they face challenges, expected or unexpected challenges. So this requires leaders to be hands-on, to be able to make decisions on the ground, to be able to remove obstacles or impediments along the way for their people, for their team and the workforce. This is building the capability, or we call agile capabilities, for the organization and for the country. At the end of the day, leaders need to be inclusive, not just inspiring, but be able to include everyone in the process of change or transformation. So this is what we see as more of a human-centric, a holistic, integrated approach to leadership, leading with head, heart, and hands. Thank you very much, Ravindra and the Asian Network, for this opportunity and this award tonight. Congratulations to all the other awardees tonight. Thank you.
Thanks, Dr. Ruseng, for sharing your triple H, head, heart, and the hands. Our next awardee is Shomi Hassan Chaudhary from Bangladesh, a multi-award winning water sanitation and hygiene activist and the co-founder of Awareness 360. In 2019, Shomi received the Princess Diana Legacy Award and has been recognized recently as a Forbes 30 Under 30 feature honoree. We would like to congratulate Shomi for her dedication and vision to ensure access to water, sanitation, and hygiene for all. The floor is yours, Shomi.
Thank you. I hope I'm audible.
All good.
Okay. Good evening, everyone. I would like to start off by thanking Mr. Ravindra for bringing us all together through this dynamic platform. I am truly honored to be recognized with the Leaders by Head and Heart Award, and I would like to express my gratitude to the Asian Network for this incredible ceremony. My name is Shomi Hassan Choudhury. I am the co-founder of Awareness 360, which is a global youth-led nonprofit that empowers young people across 23 countries with the skills and resources needed to conduct social action projects supporting the UN Sustainable Development Goals. I am a dedicated water sanitation and hygiene WASH activist, and WASH is also one of our focus areas at Awareness 360. I realized the critical role of WASH that it can play in saving lives after tragically losing my mother to diarrhea, who was sick for only one day. Losing someone you love is difficult, but losing someone from a preventable disease like diarrhea in 21st century is unacceptable. I wanted to take action to prevent others from facing the same. So 4 days after my mother's death, I conducted my first WASH talk at an isolated sewerage workers community and have continued my WASH activism ever since. As a strong believer of the leaving no one behind philosophy, Awareness 360 reached out to hard-to-reach communities like the sex workers, slum dwellers, the homeless, under-resourced school children, people with disabilities, refugees, and much more, benefiting over 150,000 people around the world. All of our accomplishments at Awareness 360 are the result of a combination of technology, collaborations, youth power, and perseverance. We can confidently assert that we will accomplish the SDGs by 2030 if young people are really empowered, not in a superficial way, but in a substantive manner across local, national, and international levels. An advice that I give to budding change makers is find your passion in what bothers you. If you are bothered by something very much, then you will take that first step of action instead of just ranting about it. Tonight's event is to celebrate leaders and leadership. I personally exercise democratic or shared leadership. I like to give the floor to my team, listen to their ideas, and complement each other's strengths and weaknesses. When I was asked during the Head and Heart podcast to describe myself using three words, I said, global citizen, empathetic, and resilient. We are going through an unprecedented time, and we have shown how resilient we are with a lens of empathy and global citizenship. We have made some significant and impressive efforts in addressing the world's pressing problems, including the global pandemic. I know each of us in this room have these values within us. We lead with our head and our heart to make this world a better place. I am leaving this room tonight with more hope about our future. Thank you again for making one of the 10 awardees tonight. I really, really appreciate this honor. Thank you.
Thanks, Shomi, for your inspiring message. Our next awardee is Mr. Cesar Yung Arada from Hong Kong. Cesar is the founder of Maker Bay, Hong Kong's first and only makerspace for social and environmental impact. He is the inventor of Protei, a revolutionary shape-shifting sailing robot. Cesar is a senior TED fellow, works at MIT as a project leader and researcher. He was a keynote speaker at the Harvard Business School, main stage speaker at the UN COP21 Climate Conference. We congratulate you for all your work and passion for the environment and the oceans. Thanks, Cesar. The floor is yours.
Thanks so much. Can you hear well?
Very good. Very well.
Excellent. Yeah. So it's a great honor to be speaking after those are great speakers and really notable individuals. So it's a great honor. I don't want to impose what my vision of what being a leader is, but I like to speak to what kind of leader that I aspire to be, or maybe I should say to become. The first thing I'd like to talk about is the priorities. I think we are facing unprecedented challenges as a species with global warming and the rapid disappearance of species, the sixth great extinction. This is not something that any any other coordinated group of individuals or animals have ever had to sort of think through. And so it commands for unprecedented coordination between us. As the first speaker, Mr. Jensen, said, that we have to think way beyond nation, and even we have to think beyond our own species. And I just want to say what I hope, what I'm doing with my business and with my also philanthropic activity, which is trying to shift the other priorities. So this is something very, very practical. If you think about how most companies and how most people do their choices today, generally first, the most important thing is making money. Is money is number one. Then number two is using technology to make more money. And then three is to use people to actually use technology to make more money. And then the environment is usually the very last priority. And because of this exact logic of putting money and tech above human beings and above the environment, we're destroying the environment. And so whatever kind of activity you are doing, whether you are something that deals with extractive activity like mining or forestry or agriculture, or even if you do something that is sort of dematerialized, working in consulting or you know, in banking, which is dematerialized increasingly, then I would say, as a leader, I think we have to prioritize first the environment. If we want to keep living in this planet, first the environment. Second is people. Without a social, healthy society, we cannot build any technological framework, and money is just a form of technology. And so I just want to really urge all you people, you are leaders in your own chief, to make decision based on your other priority, that's nature first, then people, then technology, and money as last, actually, because it's maybe the least important one. The second thing that I want to emphasize on as a leader is to build an open society where people are free to criticize each other, and where you remove the friction. When you're creating value for society, give it, make your technology open source, make your policy amendable, that people can criticize you, make those channels of communication open, be ready, expose yourself, ask criticism. And the last one, somebody already said it, is to be inclusive, is as a leader, make sure that you leave nobody behind. And that's true at any level. You don't have to be the leader to not let people behind, you know. Anybody at any level, we have to look after each other. Not only, again, the humans, but also, again, like the environment or other creatures. So that's my message for being a leader, is first having a clear order of priority that would function for all of us long-term. Second is to favor an open and equitable society. And third is to be an inclusive leader. That's what I would, that's the kind of leader that I aspire to become, and that I hope to see as well in the world. So thank you very much.
Thanks, Cesar, for your message as a leader by head and heart. Finally, our last awardee for tonight's ceremony, Leaders by Head and Heart, is Sherry Atilano from the Philippines. And we congratulate you for your work within Philippines and the agricultural sectors. Sherry is the founder and CEO of ARIA Agricultural System International, a for-purpose and inclusive business that is creating the first replicable one-island economy that is zero hunger, zero waste, and zero insufficiency. She is a food system champion of the United Nations, young global leader of the World Economic Forum, and the Philippine ambassador of food security. Welcome, Sherry. The floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Ravindra, and the Asia Network. Can you hear me okay?
Very well.
Okay. I am actually transitioning from being impressed to being in awe, in great awe of listening to all the leaders out there. It's so humbling to be one of the honorees. And thank you so much for this honor. I remember, Ravindra, my mom, you know, when you interviewed me in the podcast, I shared with you this story that when I was 6 years old, my mom asked me, what's the shortest distance in life? That's the distance between your head, your heart, and your hand. And after that, at 11, I started teaching farmers. So it's been 23 years, a journey of teaching farmers, and been from traditional to really becoming a transformational kind of leadership. So in our work in AGREA, right now we've been working with 30,000 farmers in the Philippines. This is such a responsibility for a young woman in a male-dominated industry. And to answer the question about leadership, for me, a leader is someone who makes everyone matter, not because of someone's importance, but because everyone is a human being, and so is a leader. And someone who creates a system and a place that everyone is a winner, but also recognizing the fact that the moment you become bigger, the moment you grow bigger, the smaller you are in that picture. So it's really about recognizing humility, recognizing that you're there to empower everyone, to enable them. And lastly, it is really about having that firmness on intention with inclusive on implementation. You know, with this pandemic, it has been a challenge to us, but I guess, you know, as a leader, I must say that I'm surviving and thriving because I believe that the amount of gratefulness in our heart, empathy and compassion should always be above and beyond measure. We are living in an ecosystem and everyone has a responsibility, but you know, we should learn to live together to find a commonality. And for us leaders, it is a commonality of new mindset, common purpose, and finding the goodness in everyone and uplifting everyone to be good. Thank you so much and congratulations to everyone.
Thank you, Cherry. I would like to thank and congratulate again all our awardees tonight, our sponsor ERIA and Oxygen for India, and His Excellency Franz Jessen for taking his time for the opening remarks. Before our 10-minute roundtable, where each participant will be able to network and discuss about leadership with selected topics such as environment, education, technology, among others, we will take a group selfie pictures with all participants and speaker. Okay, so sadly, we don't have more time for the roundtable session. So I will end this virtual ceremony. To all the awardees, again, congratulations for your dedication and passion in your field and for your valuable work for your community, society, and country. We salute you for your courage and passion. true connection, commitment, and leadership overcomes our difference. Princess Diana believed that young people has the power to change the world, and she said that leading from the heart is more important than leading with the head. On these words, I would like to end this virtual award ceremony. Have a wonderful evening, everyone. Thanks again to all participants and our sponsor area, the Economic Research Institute for ASEAN and East Asia. And see you next time for our next award ceremony, Leaders by Head and Heart. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you, everybody. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Ravindra.
Thank you. Good night.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you again.